Let's take a look at the nomenclature of alkyl halide. So if this is the alkyl halide and I'm trying to assign an IUPAC name for it, you follow the same steps that we did in earlier videos, right? You find the longest carbon chain involved. So let's see if we can find that. So how many carbons is the longest carbon chain? So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So 7 carbons, we called that heptane in our earlier video, so we'll go ahead and write heptane down here. So we have heptane like that. All right, now you figure out which way to number it. Do I number from the left side of the chain or do I number from the right side of the chain? Now, when you have an alkyl, when you have a halogen in there and you have alkyl groups, you want to number to give the lowest number to either the alkyl group or to the halogen. So in this case, you could either start from the left or you could start from the right. If you start from the left, you'll give that alkyl group a number 2. So if we start from the left here and I go 1, and 2 like that, so there's another 2 for that alkyl group. If I start from the right, I would give the halogen a 3. So it's the lowest number wins, so I'm going to start from the left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 like that. All right, so let's go ahead and think about how we're going to name our alkyl groups. So I have 2 methyl groups at 2 and 4, so that's 2,4-dimethyl. So I can go ahead and put that in my name. So 2,4 dimethyl heptane like that, and now I can worry about my halogen, which is at carbon number 5. So I have 5-bromo. So when you have bromine in there, you name it 5-bromo. So 5-bromo 2,4 dimethyl heptane is the correct IUPAC name for this. And you have to worry about the alphabet rule, right? So the reason why I put the bromo before the methyl is because B comes before M in the alphabet. So that would be how to name this molecule. Let's look at another molecule. Let's see. Let's go like this. All right. So let's go like that, and let's put a chlorine here, and let's put a bromine here. All right, so same idea, right? Find your longest carbon chain. All right, so let's see if we can do that. Let's see what's the longest number of carbons we have. I can have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 5 carbons would be pentane. So I go ahead and write pentane here. And next, of course, I figure out which side do I begin my numbering. Do I start from the left or do I start from the right? So if I start from the left, that would give this bromine a number 1. If I start from the right, that would give this alkyl group a number 2. So it makes sense to start from the left here. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 like that. So now I have a methyl group at carbon 4. So I can go ahead and write 4-methyl here, so 4-methyl pentane, and now I have to worry about my halogens, right? So I have a bromine at 1 and a chlorine at 3. So just so I can space a little bit better here, I know that the bromine's going to come before the chlorine because of the alphabet rule, so I can go ahead and put the chlorine right here. So the chlorine's at 3, so 3-chloro, like that. And then now I can go ahead and put my bromo in here at 1. So 1-bromo, 3-chloro, 4-methylpentane is the name for this molecule. All right, so let's do a few more. Let's look at this one here. So let's see, like that and like that. All right, so for this one, once again, same steps, right? So I think to myself, all right, here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I have hexane. So I'm going to go ahead and write that down here. So I have hexane like that. Now, when I think about how to number this one, it's a bit of a problem, right? So if I number from the left, that would give the bromine a 2. If I number from the right, that would give the methyl group a 2. So I have a tie. So how do you break that tie? It's based on the alphabet rule. So I have my substituents would be bromo versus methyl. So the B beats the M. So because the B beats the M alphabetically, that means I'm going to start from the left once again to give this a 1, this 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So think about the alphabet rule here. So now I have a methyl group at 5, right? So this would be 5-methylhexane. And then I'm going to go ahead and put in my bromine right at 2. So it'd be 2-bromo. So my full IUPAC name, 2-bromo, 5-methylhexane, like that. All right, what about stereochemistry? So what if stereochemistry is involved? What if you're giving something like this? All right, so a molecule that looks like that with a wedge there and an iodine atom there. So let's first name the molecule. Don't worry about stereochemistry, and then we'll go ahead and add stereochemistry in at the end. So once again, longest carbon chain. All right, so that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Longest carbon chain with your halogen in there. So that would be 5, so that'd be pentane. All right, so go ahead and write pentane down here, like that. Now, which side of the chain do I number from? Well, I want to get the lowest number possible, so this time I'm going to number from the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to give my substituents the lowest number possible. So I have a methyl group and an iodo, right? So I comes before M, so I'm going to go ahead and put the methyl group at the end here. So I have a methyl group at 3, so 3-methylpentane, like that. All right, and now I have an iodo group at 2, so 2-iodo. So I have 2-iodo, 3-methylpentane. I have to specify which stereoisomer I have. So we're going to assign the R or the S system here. So once again, I think about increasing atomic number, right? The highest atomic number gets the highest priority. So iodine is going to have the highest atomic number. So this substituent is going to get a number 1 for priority, right? Remember, there's also a hydrogen attached to this carbon right here. So this is my chirality center right here. So the iodine gets a number 1. The hydrogen, of course, gets number 4, lowest priority. And now I have this alkyl group on the left and this methyl group on the right. I think we know the alkyl group on the left is going to get a second highest priority, and the methyl group is going to get a third highest priority from an earlier video, right? So then we go, all right, we're going around this way, we're going around clockwise, and my hydrogen is going away from me. So going around clockwise is, of course, R. So this is going to be R 2-iodo 3-methylpentane, like that. So all of these have been the IUPAC system for naming alkyl halides. Sometimes you'll see the common names used. Okay, so what do I mean by common names? Sometimes you'll hear chemists just say, like, for this molecule right here, this is one that's used all the time, right? You just say, instead of numbering the chain and talking about, what's coming off of the carbons, you'll hear tert-butyl chloride used most often as a name for this molecule. So tert-butyl chloride, right? Because there's a tert-butyl group. So that's a common name for it. And it's so common, you'll see it all the time instead of the IUPAC name. So that's the name that I will use most often too. And another molecule, so for small alkyl halides, the common nomenclature system is used a lot. This would be ethyl bromide, right? So you're essentially naming your alkyl group, right? And then worrying about your halogen. So for both of these, for common nomenclature, think about the alkyl group and then the halogen that's attached to it. So ethyl bromide, you could call that bromoethane, right? So ethyl bromide would be the common name for it. If you wanted to use the IUPAC name, you could say it's bromoethane. Either one of those names is perfectly acceptable, all right? And you'll hear both. So the last thing that we need to do for alkyl halides is talk about the classification, right? So we've talked about classifications before in reference to things like alcohols, and it's pretty much the same thing for alkyl halides. So if I have a situation like this with a halogen attached to this carbon right here, and I want to classify this alkyl halide. Once again, you just look and see how many carbons that carbon is attached to. So the carbon attached to my halogen is attached to one other carbon, and that makes this a primary alkyl halide. All right, so that's a primary alkyl halide. And same concept if we had this situation. Right, and I want to classify this alkyl halide. This is my carbon that's attached to my halogen. So I think to myself, how many carbons are attached to that? Right, there are two of them, right, which makes this a secondary alkyl halide. And then, of course, if we had a situation like this, right, and I want to classify this alkyl halide, once again, I just look at the carbons attached. So, of course, 1, 2, and 3. So this is a tertiary alkyl halide. So if you look at these two examples we just did for our common nomenclature, tert-butyl chloride, right? So same idea. This is our alkyl halide, and I see 1, 2, 3, right? So this would be a tertiary alkyl halide. And For ethyl bromide, right, this carbon right here is attached to one other carbon. So this would be an example of a primary alkyl halide. So this will be your first step when you're doing some reactions of alkyl halides to recognize how it is classified.